Hello, my friends. It's time again for the Morning Mindset. I'm so glad that you're here for this opportunity for us to get our minds aligned with the truth of God. Because when our minds are aligned with God's truth, we're able to live a life that is aligned with God's truth. And that really is what matters as followers of Jesus Christ. Today, we'll be looking at Proverbs chapter 6, verses 20 through 22. Don't go away. We're going to get into that right away. But first, I want to remind you about our Friday Pray Together episodes. These are longer episodes that we publish in addition to this 6-minute episode. And it's an episode where I pray for actual requests that have come in from the Morning Mindset listening family. If you would like to submit your prayer request, you can do so either using your name or anonymously. And you can do it at carreygreen.com/prayer, C-A-R-E-Y, green like the color, .com/prayer. You should be able to find that link in the description for this episode as well. All right, Proverbs chapter 6, verses 20 through 22. Here Solomon returns to his fatherly approach, and he says, "My son, keep your father's commandment and forsake not your mother's teaching. Bind them on your heart always. Tie them around your neck. When you walk, they will lead you. When you lie down, they will watch over you. And when you awake, they will talk with you." This is a very interesting passage because Solomon is describing the wisdom of a mother or a father who come alongside their child to instruct them as things that are long-term valuable in their lives. He says, they're so valuable, you should bind them on your heart always. So we should really take the instruction we receive from our parents very seriously. Now, of course, Solomon is talking about a godly mother and father. You may not have experienced the blessing of a godly mother or father, and you may have actually experienced the exact opposite from their hand. So Solomon is both laying out something we should be aspiring to, but he's also telling us where you did receive wisdom, you should be applying that wisdom in your own life. He says, bind them on your heart always, tie them around your neck. And the practical outgrowth of doing so is that when you walk, they will lead you. So imagine yourself walking down a mountain path or a desert road that you've never been down before, and you come to the fork in the road, so to speak, and you don't know which way to go. He's saying the wisdom you receive from the practical instruction of your mother and father will help you make the decision when you reach life's forks in the road. He says, when you lie down, they will watch over you. So he's saying when you rest, when you're not out there diligently working, when you're not pursuing something, you can rest with confidence and with peace, knowing that you've been living your life in a wise way. And then he says, and when you awake, they will talk with you. I don't know if you have this experience, but my wife often wakes up with thoughts in her mind that she did not generate. These things that God places in her mind, in her heart, about situations that are going on or people she's been interacting with. And she just, from that sleepy state, is suddenly aware as she's rising, as she's stirring in bed, that here's this little jewel of wisdom that's in her mind related to so-and-so. And she'll ponder those. She'll pray about those things. And so many times she and I will discuss those things because they turn out to be little gifts from God that come from the cultivation of wisdom in her life. And my friends, that can be and should be me and you who are receiving that kind of wisdom from the Lord. Now, I'm not saying you'll wake up with God's wisdom tomorrow if you start thinking in this way, but I am saying that what Solomon is teaching us here is true. When we value and apply the wise things that parents and others have invested into our lives, we begin to realize these things guide us. They watch over us. They speak to us in the unguarded moments of life to give us insight into the situations we face and to give us resources to guide and help others. My friends, I don't know about you, but I want to be that kind of wise person because I want to represent my Savior, Jesus Christ, who was the ultimate of this kind of wise person. Jesus, fill us up with yourself and with your wisdom. We want our lives to reflect you, to represent you in honorable and powerful and true ways. We want our lives to be guided by your insight in your direction. So please fill us up with your divine wisdom that we can receive the benefits and bless others. In Jesus' name, we pray.